Standing here with the dudes from Between the Baird and Me, guys, first question, what's tighter, your music or your pants?
Our music on a good night, but that's rare.
And I don't wear tight pants.
You don't wear tight pants?
None of us wear extremely tight pants at all.
Yeah.
So who shops in the girls department, in the band?
Actually.
That's not trendy at all.
I don't know. I mean, I like nice clothes, but I buy a guy nice clothes.
Right, so. Definitely. I agree with you guys.
So recently you guys announced that Dusty is officially the fifth member of the band.
See.
And you're going to be doing Glass Casket now and Between the Baird and Me.
Busy boy.
So how does it feel to be such a well-rounded musician?
Well,
all I can do is play.
He plays guitar in both bands. It's not like he's doing something weird. His talent is fairly limited.
How do you feel about the rest of the band diminishing your great?
I don't know, man. I like to play metal in my band. I guess school's more important to them than rocking, but they're all good guys, and I like playing with them, and I really like playing with these guys too. So basically, I've been put here to rock, and that's what I'm gonna do.
So, you guys wouldn't mind elaborating, like, what happened with Shane? Like, why did
it just didn't work out, honestly, man. A lot of little things here and there. Nothing. Just personal stuff, you know.
His mom got in the way a lot. Yeah, seriously.
She was the Yoko Ono of Between the Baird and Me?
Yeah.
Not really. She was like his legal representative.
She was like his mom, basically. In every situation.
Yeah.
Was she complaining that he didn't get to bed on time or anything like that?
She just wanted him to get more solos, and she wanted him to stand at the center of the stage.
Now we're lying.
Yeah. Now we're lying.
And she wanted Tommy on stage left. She wanted Shane front and center.
Oh, I see.
No, I'm just kidding. No, it was just, it just didn't work out. He was, he just wasn't as cool as us, and it didn't work out.
Differences personally and musically.
So. I see.
So what are some, like, crazy things that happened on this tour that you probably didn't expect or anything?
Broke down for 4 days in San Francisco. That sucked. Our brakes basically blew up and ripped apart, and hoses ripped out of our van, and it was a nightmare. And we were stranded. Had to cancel 3 shows.
Found out our merch got by. We never knew that.
Which is cool. We supported.
Yeah, but it's fine. So. It's just,
how did you find out?
He started fucking Tommy.
No, he didn't do that, but it just kind of came up one day.
Nah, it just came up. I mean, we were like, cool, you know, we support you or whatever. It was just,
us
weird.
It was kind of awkward.
We didn't know. It was cool.
Cool. All right, so let's get to the beefy questions, right? Do you guys eat beef? No. It's a bad one. Oh, vegan? I'm sorry. So not everyone is like vegan in the band?
Only two guys in the band and our bisexual merch guys.
I see. So,
straight edge bisexual math merch atheist Starbucks grumpy militia.
That describes our merch.
That describes our merch.
That's nice.
So, like, seriously though, like, how do you guys come up with these songs? Like, there are like 50 parts in every song. Like, what's the songwriting?
Basically, just revamp Simon and Garfunkel songs. Just spice them up, make them metal.
It's basically like a big puzzle, man. We just write, you know, we kind of write riffs on our own time and get together. Just kind of put songs together and get ideas of what we want in each song, what direction we want to go in certain songs. And like with the Silent Circus, we kind of wrote the album as one big song. We started from the beginning and wrote in that order all the way to the end of the record, just kind of with the ideas, you know, to make it a little sort of mellow in the middle and real intense after that. And it's just kind of how we've always done it.
So how did you guys pick your costumes for tonight's show?
Basically, we love 80s metal, so we went with that route, and Paul's got a little...
I love afros.
Yeah, he loves
Paul
afros.
And I went to get food at this place in Syracuse, and there was a wig store right next door, and we're like, fuck it.
I brought my wig with me.
Let's get a badass wig.
When can we expect new material from Between
Woo!
The
Baird? We're taking time off in the Dark Sour tour for hopefully a month or two, start writing a lot, because we really haven't had any time to really write much. And we don't really know, like, a time period, no later than summer next year.
We definitely got some riffs.
Yeah, it takes a while, right?
You know, just
can you like mouth some of those riffs?
Let's see.
Like that. Sounds like a hit.
Oh, is up next. Thank you very much.